big data is any size of data bigger than what you're used to dealing with.
Once you're used to it, it's not big anymore.
I would say very simply, big data is the digitization of life.
And from that, we try to garner meaning.
Big data is data that poses tremendous opportunities.
The data is extraordinarily complex, extraordinarily diverse, and typically extraordinarily large.
And this has challenged our ability to deal with it, make inference from it.
I prefer the term data science as opposed to big data.
Data science is manipulating large amounts of data to answer questions that we couldn't answer previously.
Stanford Medicine is leading the biomedical revolution in precision health. And biomedical data science provides the foundation that will allow us to realize this goal and transform biomedicine in the 21st century.
When we think about big data, we think about all the excitement of all the different data sources. But ultimately, it's really sort of the discipline of data sciences that underlies the methodology, the tools, the approaches, the way we synthesize that information to really extract knowledge from data.
Data science is what statistics became in the 21st century when other people besides statisticians began taking it seriously as a discipline.
But it also has an emphasis on the fact that we use data to generate our hypotheses on how the world looks.
So why should the average person care about data science? Well, you know, it's interesting to think about all the impacts that could come.
We can learn so much about you, your DNA, billions of other measurements that we can make both on your molecules to understand your health state, as well as all the things you do in terms of your activity. So the goal is really to make these measurements and understand people as soon as problems arise. Again, maybe before they even realize it.
As the father of a child that has benefited directly from whole genome sequencing, I can say unequivocally that a diagnosis has given us much hope and a lot to look forward to and a lot to work on.
Can we use information about a patient's genome or about their exposures out in the world to make precise drug prescribing decisions? And can we use information to figure out how we can combine medications, perhaps even using old drugs to treat new diseases?
We actually use large-scale machine learning to try to understand how to better design drugs. And it's allowed us to make impacts in many different areas, especially basic biophysics and drug design in the areas of Alzheimer's and infectious disease.
One of the things we've learned using big data is that how to make better surgical decisions. And we've made discoveries about which surgical procedures, for example, will lead to greater mobility in people who have cerebral palsy.
In our research, what we've done is taken data from retinal scans, which are required at every visit here for patients with macular degeneration, and created a mathematical model in order to be able to predict which patients might be getting worse and which patients should be safe from progression.
We're looking at how the big data about where people come from, where they live, can help us in terms of outreach and help us in terms of improving the care that people with hepatitis B get.
Stanford has a lot of exciting advantages in data science. We're all on the same campus, people who do work in informatics and computer science, people who understand the ethics and the security issues related to big data.
We've been doing data science at Stanford for many years. What's new these days is bringing together the scientists that are generating data with the ones that are that understand how to analyze the data to make new discoveries.
We've got people doing remarkably innovative work across the spectrum, ranging from very basic biology all the way out to the studies of physical environment, social environment, public health, and so forth.
Stanford School of Medicine has arguably the best biomedical research program in the world, right next to Stanford Hospital, one of the world's leading hospitals. And the cool thing is that all of our labs and groups in computer science, engineering, physics, biology, biochemistry, we're all right next to each other.
This is really something that brings together all of Stanford and all of Stanford's strengths. And then we can reach outside of the Stanford campus to our neighbors who are in the technology industry who've been using data science to transform the world around us.
Oh, it's going to be very, very exciting because I think we're going to be making more and more discoveries about how individuals can prevent disease and increase their health and therefore their quality of life.
Looking into the future, I see us as a more informed society I see scientists working in domains that they didn't expect to work in because they have access to data they didn't have access before. And I do see that it's going to help the individual because I do believe this information is going to translate into decisions that will empower the individual to make better choices.
I think that big data could serve as a democratization of the scientific process and also lead to science moving towards a more patient-centered and patient-driven approach.
I think that the vast amounts of data that we're going to generate on patients, whether it be from their blood samples, whether it be from measuring them with new mobile sensors on their wrists, from measuring them in the outside, from measuring them in the hospital, I think we're going to have so much more data, and I think we're going to be able to bring it to bear to diagnose the patients better and then to target therapies better so that we can make a more personalized healthcare system for the future.